Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Tony Conigliaro Memorial Gymnasium, home of St. Mary's basketball. It's the second season for the boys team, basketball-wise, taking on arch rival Fenwick for the third time this year. This is the quarterfinals with no state tournament. They opted to have a Catholic Central League Cup tournament. So they finished the season, and now they seeded the teams through their records, and they'll get to play some more basketball games. So this is the quarterfinal round. These two teams have played twice. They split. Three-point basket by Jason Romano gets Fenwick off and running. Home court hasn't made a bit of difference for either of these two teams. St. Mary's soundly beat Fenwick at Fenwick. Fenwick beat them here, a much closer game. St. Mary's was leading. The big play in the game, Che Hanks, who has the basketball right now, just passing it. He hit a three-point shot, got fouled, made it a four-point play as Barry drops it in. That gave them the lead going into the fourth period. They held St. Mary's to 10 points in the fourth period, and they won it 60-54. So both teams have not held serve at home. Nice give and go to Lozier. He set the screen, gave it back, and then was wide open for the layup. The winner of this will take on Archbishop Williams at Archbishop Williams. Feels shot way too strong. David Brown, St. Mary's grad, on the bench. He's here with Brother Dawn, who's a very good athlete at Lynn Tech. Also Brian Mulvey and Mike Dietria. Kevin Moran, the head guy for St. Mary's. An outstanding player at St. Mary's. Partially blocked, they save it. From dead in the corner, three no good. Sacco gives it to Brown. And Kevin Moran has a bunch of St. Mary's former very good players. They were lucky to get that ball back. David Brown attempting to get a tough shot off. David Brown got the rebound. Cut it up, but went in the rim and came back out again. David Brown Sr. looking for a foul. Probably should have got one. But Kevin Rand has a bunch of St. Mary's former very good athletes. Are they counting the basket or are they calling it on the floor? They're not giving them the basket. They're calling it on the drive. NBA, that would have been a three-point play. St. Mary's problems this year have been getting off the slide, and they've had long periods of not scoring. Off the rim, no good. Bodies go down. Jackson Field and Ali Barry both blocked a shot by Che Hanks. For St. Mary's, Nick Sacco was 23. Jackson Field is 5. David Brown Jr. is 2. As we got a three-point basket. We got a blocking foul. That three-point basket was Max Granert. Timmy Batista is 12 and Ali Barry is 4. For Fenwick, 1 is Jason Romano, 4 is Jay Hanks, 20 is Max Granert. 24 is Alex Gonzalez as David Brown throws in a 3. And 33 is Christian Loja. He almost lost that out of bounds. 8-5, Fenwick. Just past the halfway mark. Barry takes it away to Baptista. Out in front, lays it in. Baptista with the basket. Barry with the nice defensive play and the pass. And Samiri's back within a point. Fenwick just throws it away. Kevin Moran shaking his head. It was going well for a while. Now all of a sudden, Samiri's back in it. That unforced error gives coaches gray hair. And Kevin Moran called the timeout to talk about it. Eight to seven. The winner of this will have to go to Brockton to play Archbishop Williams. Unless either Arlington Catholic or Bishop Stang, who played in the first opening round, can knock off Archbishop Williams. Williams would have to lose for the winner of this to get a home game. St. Mary's girls will start tomorrow night. They'll take on Austin Prep in their opening round. St. Mary's girls hockey soundly defeated Archbishop Williams Saturday night to move on for a very tough game against Austin Prep. They played Austin Prep 3 times. There's 1 goal difference. David Brown with another 3. And St. Mary's leads. Shot doesn't go, but he'll get to the foul line after David Brown with the pick. So St. Mary's has their first lead at 10-8. David Brown will get 2 at the line. He's got 7 of their 11. 2 big 3-point shots. Missed that one, tipped up. Fenwick comes away with it. So it's 11-8, straight man to man, but they'll double when they get the chance. 3-point shot, no good. Barry with the rebound. Pushing it quickly. Strong to the basket, gets it to go. Barry got that rebound. He said, here I come, get out of my way. Coast to coast. St. Mary's has their biggest lead, 13-8. Steps taken. Eight in a row by St. Mary's. They were trailing 8-5. David Brown down the lane. He gets it to go. Looked like he was going to get it blocked. He laid it in. Come on, looking for a conventional three. He's already got 2 3-point baskets. Strong drive, and he laid it in. He's got the 3-point play. He's got 10 points. He's got more than Fenwick. He's outscoring Fenwick, and now he reaches in, steals it away again. Batista for three, off the rim, no good. Fenwick lost it out of bounds. 11 in a row by Shape Marys. Most of them by David Brown. Another 3-point basket by Brown. He can't miss. All of a sudden, it's 19-8. Been a long drought for Fenwick. They led 8-5. A long 3-point bomb. Tip from Brown to Sacco. Batista spins away. David Brown again. Tip, Field comes down with the rebound. Batista for three. Jackson Field gets another rebound. Barry's shot is blocked. And we got a foul against Fenwick. That was a little bit late. I'm not sure what they're calling because David Brown's going to get two at the line. Fenwick has already committed 6 fouls. He's got 14 points. In and out. So they called an unsportsmanlike foul against Fenwick. So Samiris gets the free throws and the ball. Under a minute and counting. Barry lost it off his foot. Basket goes. That ends a long drought. Hanks kissed it off the glass and got fouled. St. Mary's were on a 15-0 run after they trailed 8-5. Omri Merriman coming in the game. Sackles going out. Hanks looking for a 3-point play. Gets the bounce. Then Mirish can take the last shot. Big first period for St. Mary's, offensively and defensively. A big period for David Brown. Batista hits the shot. The buzzer, they threw it up and got it off the rim, but couldn't get it to go. So it was 8-5 Fenwick. Fenwick went a long time before they got a 3-point play by Hanks with under a minute left. Meanwhile, St. Mary's put up 17. They outscored Fenwick 17-3, 15-0 at one point. And at the end of one, St. Mary's has doubled up on Fenwick. It's St. Mary's 22, Fenwick 11. St. Mary's has the basketball and 11-point lead. David Brown, what a period. 14 points. He outscored Fenwick 14-11. St. Mary's only had 3 scorers, but it's nice when one of them has got 14 points. Barry got in close, couldn't get the layup to go, and got tied up. It'll be Fenwick's basketball. Calanzas is in the ball game for St. Mary's. Hanks bounced it off his foot. Mervin comes up with a loose basketball. So again, St. Mary's has a chance to get on the board first here in the second period. Batista with a tough shot. Fenwick looking to run. Great bounce pass, we got a foul. Terrific pass from Romano. Colby Brown will get two at the line. This one doesn't go. So it's Merriman, Brown, Batista, Barry, and Calanzas, the five out there for St. Mary's here, starting the second period. No good again, he missed them both. Tough shot by David Brown. He got tied up. They lose it again off their foot. Another turnover. And now St. Mary's returns the favor by throwing it out of bounds. Fenwick's had a couple of dribbling the basketball off their foot and losing it. A long three-point bomb, no good. Barry's a little too strong to the basket. Tipped around. They save it to Batista. Barry for three, around the rim and out. St. Mary's. Ties up Gonzalez, it'll be St. Mary's basketball. Just about 2 minutes into this second period, looking for our first points. Looks like Fenwick's in the zone now. A 2-3 zone. Short, no good. We got a foul against Merriman. Only the fourth team foul. Fenwick has already committed six, so St. Mary's will be going to the line. So Kevin Moran has gone away from man-to-man. He's gone with 2-3 zone. Around the rim and good by Gonzalez. They get on the board first. They block the shot. But Calanzas gets it to go anyway. He's going to look for a three-point play. Good strong move by Calanzas. They got a piece of the basketball, but he continued, laid it in. And he can give St. Mary's the biggest lead of 12 if he makes this free throw. Hanks comes back for Fenwick. Off the rim, no good. Merriman comes away with the rebound. Everything going St. Mary's way here in the first half. Barry took steps. He faked going left, started to go right and dragged that back left foot before he put the ball on the floor. So we played almost 3 minutes. And it's 2-2. Almost threw that one away. Strong drive to the basket. Gonzalez, he gets fouled. He'll get two at the line. St. Mary still has one foul to waste before Fenwick shoots after these free throws. That's another free throw. Boy, Fenwick can't get anything done. They went that long stretch after they led 8-5. They went well, like 40 seconds left before they got a three-point play by Hanks while St. Mary's was running off 15 in a row. Gonzalez gets it down to a 10-point lead. From dead in the corner, no good. Fenwick comes away with the rebound. They almost lost it. A long three-point bomb, no good. Yeah, we're going to get a foul against Fenwick, and that's going to put St. Mary's at the free throw line. All kinds of people banging into each other, trying to get to the rebound, blocking away from the rebound. Galanzis will get one on one. He needs the first to get the second. Didn't get it. Fenwick has a chance to get it into single digits. As we're approaching halfway. Good move to the basket by Grenert. Good strong move by Grenert. Waited to deliver a bomb and laid it in. And the lead is down to 8. As we're halfway through and counting the second period. Anthony Dietrich is in the ball game right now. Pass deflected away. David Brown lines up the shot, no good. Fenwick can get a little closer. A long three-point bomb, no good. Great pass from Calangis to Dietria. He threw it by everybody. The bounce pass right in the lap of Dietria for the layup. From dead in the corner. It bounces a couple of times. Everybody up in here, Kalinji was the only one to get ready to come down with it. From dead in the corner, no good. Tip and knocked out by St. Mary's. Baptista goes out. Jackson Field is in. Again, Fenwick with a chance to get it into single digits. They've been settling for those long three-point bombs. Hanks blocked nicely by David Brown. Just went up and blocked it and took it away. From dead in the corner, a shot, no good. Another long three-point bomb. This one goes by Grenert. And the lead is down to 7. We got a timeout. 2 minutes straight up to play in the second period. St. Mary's is led by as many as 11 at the end of the first period. Mm-hmm. 26-19. This is a quarterfinal round. We mentioned before, because of the virus, no state tournament. But the Catholic Central League, and now I think the Cape Ann League is doing the same thing. Got together and said, let's have a Catholic Central League Cup tournament. So at the end of the year, they seeded the teams by their records. And this is the quarterfinal round. Normally, I would say, welcome to Thanksgiving in February, because these two teams were Thanksgiving rivals in football for so long, but that little bit of a blowout they had last year or the year before. Fenwick stopped playing St. Mary's on Thanksgiving Eve. I'm not sure why, because they still have to play them in the league. And there's some Lynn kids from Fenwick who would like to play Thanksgiving at Manning Field. Barry Strong to the basket with the lefty, lays it in. Strong man-to-man defense by St. Mary's. He tried to go inside, stuck. 3-point shot, no good. Romano saved that. The layup doesn't go. All around the rim and out by Gonzalez. From dead in the corner, no good. And we got a push-off foul against Merriman. That's the third foul on Merriman. He has to go to the bench. Jackson Field comes in. A minute and counting left in the second period. I mentioned before, it's the rubber match between these two teams. I think Hanks was looking for a foul. He got knocked down. At the last second, he just said, if I throw this up, maybe they'll call a foul. He threw it up high off the glass and it went in. Short, no good. Fenwick can get a lot closer. Stolen away. It wound up on the floor. Granette said thank you and took it and laid it in. And Fenwick is within five. St. Mary's can take the last shot. St. Mary's only has, after getting 22 in the first period, they've only got six here in the second period. And they've let Fenwick back in. Barry Short off the glass and in at the buzzer. That's a big basket. He pushes the lead to eight. He didn't call glass, but he'll take it. St. Mary's winds up with only 9 points in the second period. So Fenwick eats a little bit. They cut it down to five. That 3-point basket pushes it to eight. It's St. Mary's 31, Fenwick 23 at halftime. So David Brown outscored Fenwick 14-11 in that first period, but he was held scoreless in the second period. St. Mary's only got 6 points until Allie Barry hit that bank three at the buzzer to push the lead back to eight. Fenwick has the basketball. So Fenwick only got 12 in the second period. They weren't on fire either. But holding St. Mary's to 10, they picked up a couple of points. Gonzalez hits the shot. And the lead is six. St. Mary's won long stretches in that second period. After going on that big 15 to nothing run in the first, finishing up the period at 17-3. Barry with another three. Yeah. Lead is back to 9. They throw it out of bounds. Again, those unforced efforts, errors. You wonder why coaches get gray hair. Brown, Batista, Sacco, Barry, and Field, the five that started the game, out there for St. Mary's. 3-point basket, David Brown getting back in the swing of things. 2 3-point baskets against the Deuce by Fenwick has pushed the lead back up to 12. Hanks for 3. No good. Easy follow, they missed it. Pleasure had an easy gimme. And he didn't get up high enough. Brown shot, no good. Hanks will push it up. Shot up and good. Grenert. Batista against Hanks. Jackson Fields takes the shot. It's short. Gonzalez tracks down the rebound. Fenwick can get it back into single digits. Quick 3-point shot around the rim and out. Batista's shot in and out. Deflects away. They give it to Romano. Off the rim and good. That's Gonzalez. And the lead is back to 8, which is where it was at halftime. Perry can't hit it. Followed by Sacco. Sacco, he tipped it back up. Around the rim and out. Three-point basket around the rim and out. That would have been huge. Just past the halfway mark of this third period. Tough shot by Batista. Sacco there to clean up the glass. He got hit as he was falling backwards. Off the rim and out, but he'll get 2 at the line. Good hard work by Sacco inside. He can get it back to double digits if he can make 2 here. That one's no good. They tip it, they almost lost it. Gonzalez saved it. Off the glass and in, coast to coast by Gonzalez. 6 in the period. The lead is down to 7. Batista with a little turnaround. Hank shot blocked. Barry got a piece, knocked it out. Get up, get up. He tried to go inside. Short off the rim, no good. Tipped up. Lesja around the rim and out. That would have been huge. It got tipped into his lap. He got hit as he took the shot. Around the rim and out. He'll get two at the line. Makes the first. He can get it back to seven. Sacco goes out. Zach Bodden is in for the first time. No good. So we're dead even here. In the third period, it was eight. St. Mary's at halftime. It's eight now. With just under 3 minutes remaining. A wild shot by David Brown, but he draws the contact. David Brown at the line for two. The lead is back to 10, back and forth we go. Gonzalez with a great fake. Went inside, stopped, let the defense go by and laid it in. 2 minutes and counting left. Inside to Bodden. Bodden lays it in. Powered his way in. They got it inside, two defenders. He just powered his way in, got it up, got it to go. And he's got the lead to 10. He can make it 11. Missed the shot. That went around and came out. The runner by Hanks gets his own rebound. Kicks it out for three, no good. Rebound inside, up and good by Gonzalez. He's got 10 in the period. The lead is back to eight, so they're still, St. Mary went on that big 15-0 run after Fenwick led 8-5. They continued 17-3. To finish out the first period at 22-11. It's been back and forth ever since. Fenwick sliced three off that 11-point lead at halftime. So it was eight at halftime, and it's back to eight again. So they played dead even. Both teams with 13 points here in this second period. Gonzalez has 10 of them for Fenwick. David Brown came back to life after getting 14 in the first period. Didn't score in the second period. He's got five more here in the third period. Get David Brown with a strong move again. Little lefty spinning move. Hanks gets it back. The rest of the way, Shamirs will graciously match baskets with Fenwick because they got an 8-point lead. Fenwick has got a cup with a couple of stops, try and get the ball back. Batista can't hit the shot. Jump ball, it'll be St. Mary's basketball. Calandrius and Baden. They tied up Granert. 40 seconds left in the period. David Brown draws the contact again. They gave him a lane, he took it, and they had to reach in and grab him. He's back at the line for two. That's his sixth point from the free throw line. He's got 22. Make it 23. And the lead is back to 10. Fenwick can't get it under that 8 points. When they did, St. Mary's answered back. Shot clock is just about off. Gonzalez charge. He went down high. He's getting up, thank God. They called the charge on Gonzalez. St. Mary's has 5 seconds to get a shot off. Kind of dry up the spot where we went down. So 5.8 seconds for St. Mary's to get a shot off. They lead by 10, so they've won the period by 2 if they do nothing here. No good. Romano almost tapped that one into his own basket, trying to knock the rebound away. So St. Mary's held Fenwick at bay. Every time Fenwick looked like make a little bit of a run, St. Mary's answered back. They kept the lead most of the time at 8. Those last two free throws by David Brown pushes it up to 10. It's St. Mary's 48, Fenwick 38, with 8 minutes of basketball left. Fenwick has the basketball. St. Mary's has a 10-point lead. We have 8 minutes left to see who wins the shootout between these two very intense rivals. The winner of this game wins the series. Turnaround up and good. That's Granert. He's got 14 points. And the lead is back to 8. Stolen away by Romano. David Brown with a great defensive play. Inside the circle, what a turnaround that is. Romano was trying to stop and fake and get David Brown off his feet. David Brown just swatted it away. So he's done it offensively, he does it defensively. So instead of the lead being down to 6, it's up to 10. Tough pass, you can't make those. David Brown picked it off. Inside the Sacco. Four in a row by Sacco. Nice pass by Batista. And St. Mary's has their biggest lead of the game, 12. No good. Tipped away. Turnaround, no good. The kick out to Gonzalez. Hits it for three. David Brown didn't like what was going on there. He called a timeout. One tick under 6 minutes left in this one. The winner will win the series. They split. St. Mary's lost here, won at Fenwick. The winner continues on. The loser is done for the year. And some of the basketball players for Fenwick can start getting ready for football. And it's good to know that St. Mary's going to get four or five football games at Manning Field. I guess Kip will be there as well. We hope English and Classical are not far behind. With everybody playing, everybody wondered who English and Classical would play, but they're going to the GBL League, and not the GBL, Everett, Medford, Malden, Somerville, Revere is there now, Chelsea. They're not, they're starting the same time English and Classical, so they have plenty of teams to play. They just have to get permission to get going. A 9-point lead with under 6 minutes left. Batista in and out. Gonzalez just rips the rebound away. Three-point shot, not close. Calangis got the rebound, St. Mary's will bring it back. St. Mary's would like to kill as much of the 30-second clock as they can and shorten the game up. David Brown off the pass from Barry. He's got 26. What a game he's having. The lead is back to 11. They almost lost it from dead in the corner. 3-point basket by Romano. He got one way back in the first period. And the lead is back to, you guessed it, 8 points. The teams have played dead even here in the second half. Steps called against Barry. Gonzalez will bring it up. Three-point shot. Yenton knocks it down. And they're as close as they've been in a long time. Five, they cut it to five once before. And St. Mary's got it back up to double digits. Barry throws it in. He got 9 in the first half. He only had 3 before that basket. That's his second basket in the second half. The lead is back up to 7. And we're 4 seconds past the halfway mark, so we got a lot of time left. St. Mary's has been able to answer the challenge. After Fenwick led 8-5, St. Mary's had 15-0 run in the first period, close out the period at 17-3 to grab an 11-point lead at the end of one. They've been leading ever since. The closest Fenwick came in the second period, they closed it to 5. St. Mary's got it back to 8 at halftime. They've closed it to 5 here in this fourth period, and St. Mary's got it back up to 7 on that basket by Barry. Fenwick has 49 points. Barry and Brown together have 40. So every possession now extremely important for both teams. As Gonzalez still will give it to Hanks to bring up. Gonzalez shot is short. David Brown ahead to Barry. It goes and he gets fouled. Everybody in the place thought he traveled, but he's got those long legs. He took that long stride from his left side of the basket to the right side of the basket, laid it in. He's got two big baskets here in the fourth period, looking for a three-point play. He can get it back up to double digits. No good. Hanks, a little out of control going to the basket, but he got a break because he got fouled. He'll get two at the line. Calanzas with the foul, only the second team foul. Fenwick has committed 6, St. Mary's will be going to the line. Anytime Fenwick fouls. Fenwick has actually won second, third, and fourth periods, but that first period where they fell behind by 11 has cost them. Hanks gets it to 7. Collins just thought about it, didn't take it. Merriman will take the 3 and knock it down. Huge basket by Merriman. From that exact same spot, strong drive to the basket by Lozier. That same exact spot by Merriman. He hit a 3 from there that I'm not sure whether it was Cathedral or one of those games that tied the game, and then he got a free throw to win the game. So he likes that spot. The lead is back to, you guessed it, 8. Merriman again! Back-to-back threes. Sacco blocked the shot and took it away. St. Mary's going to win this one. They're going to win the series against arch rival Fenwick. It's going to be 2-1 St. Mary's in the three-game series. And they commit the foul. David Brown will go to the free throw line. So every time Fenwick looked like they might be coming back, a couple of times they cut it to 5. St. Mary's behind Brown and Barry went to work, and now behind two mammoth three-point shots by Merriman. Brown missed it, got his own rebound, lost it. Gonzalez took it away to Hanks. Three-point shot from the corner is good by Romano, but it's not going to be enough. And with 1:31 left, can you take a guess at what the difference is? It's 8 points. That's been a magic number for St. Mary's. They've been up double digits. Fenwick comes back, St. Mary's gets it back to 8. Fenwick cut it to 5, they got it back to double digits. Fenwick cuts it to 8, but there's only 1:30 left. Those two humongous three-point shots. Virtually took the wind out of the sails of Fenwick. They're still working hard. But they're three possessions behind with 1.5 minutes left. And St. Mary's has the basketball. And Fenwick can't foul because they'll put St. Mary's at the free throw line. St. Mary's going to try and run as much clock as they can. Merriman thought about it, didn't take it. And we're going to get a reach-in foul against Granert. Merriman. David Brown is discussing something with one of the officials. I'm not sure, the official saying he can't come out in the court or. Merriman needs the first to get the second. Well, he's come on strong. He's got 7 big points in this fourth period. Make it 8. And the lead is back to 10. Merriman goes out, Dietrier is in. 1:16 left. St. Mary's gonna pick up their 12th win. Fenwick is gonna finish at 9-8. And St. Mary's has fouls to waste. So they go out and they foul just to run some time off the clock. They've got 3 more before Fenwick shoots. Blocked inside, taken away. And David Brown gets fouled as he makes the pass. Gonzalez went in, tried to get the shot off, they blocked it. David Brown was gonna make the pass, they grabbed him. And he'll get 1-on-1 at the line. Nasheem Cleopath in the game for Baptiste. So St. Mary's gonna live to play again. David Brown gets the bounce. What a game he's having, offensively and defensively. Points. 1 minute and counting. Hanks goes to the basket. Lays it in, they call foul time. '68-'58 with 57 seconds left. So we told you they split during the year. Home court advantage meant nothing because Fenwick beat St. Mary's here. St. Mary's beat Fenwick there. And now St. Mary's gonna hold serve here at home. So they'll split here at home against Fenwick, but they'll win the series 2-1. And ever since that little to-do Thanksgiving Eve at Fenwick, the football game, every game St. Mary's plays against Fenwick is virtually a must-win, and win by as much as you can. Some of the players know each other. Some of the players from Fenwick. They don't list their town. Some of them may be from Lynn. They probably know each other from AAU. Allie Barry is the quarterback for the football team. And he tried to hit David Brown, who's a wide receiver for the football team. And they do a very good job there. They were practicing for, in a couple of weeks, they'll be playing. So there's still 57 seconds left, and Fenwick will get the basketball. They forced that shot, and they're saying he got hit on the arm. They're going to give him three at the line. Michael Yenton got a big three-point basket to get them back within five in this period. He took that shot very quickly. He didn't hit anything, but they said they hit him on the arm, so they're giving him three. He misses the first. It's a shame if he missed, if he made all three. If he makes two, we could get back within eight. In and out. Merriman with the rebound. Now we got a foul. He'll get two at the line because Fenwick is in double penalty. So now we're just playing out the string. And Aries doesn't need any more points. So two at the line. Remember who came up huge. He makes this, he'll be the third player for St. Mary's in double digits, and he did it all in the fourth period. Gets the bounce. He came on in the fourth period. Shot, no good. They grabbed David Brown. And it's just academic here. David Brown will get two. David Brown's going to empty his bench. John Donahue is in. Martin Marenghi is in. Maxfield is in. Joshua Quintana is in. And they're waiting to replace David Brown. Missed a shot. Hanks for three. Knocks it down. Yeah, we got another foul. Yeah, David Brown's back at the line for two more. If he makes this one, he'll have 30. Fenwick taking their seniors out. Thomas Hooks will be on the floor as a varsity player for the first time. Strong drive to the basket. Franklin Quinton will get two at the line. He gets on the board. Makes them both. I don't think they're going to foul. They're just going to hold the ball out. Backcourt violation with 3 seconds left. So St. Mary's is going to go to 12-5. They're going to continue on to the semifinals in their quest for the Catholic Central League Cup. And they'll win the series against Fenwick. 2-1, they get home court back against Fenwick. Fenwick kept battling back. St. Mary's had that big first period. They went on a 15-0 run after Fenwick led 8-5. They finished the period 17-3 to open up an 11-point lead at the end of the first period. Fenwick actually outscored them over the last three periods by 2 points to cut that 11-point lead to 9. They got it down to 5 in the second period. St. Mary's extended it to 8. Then Fenwick got it down to 5 in the fourth period. St. Mary's extended it to double digits again. And when they got it to 5, Merriman came up with those two big mammoth 3-point baskets. Sacco came up with a couple of big baskets. And that gave them some room. Merriman got 10 points in the fourth period to help St. Mary's hold off Fenwick. And every time Fenwick made a run, St. Mary's was there to push it back up the double digits, and it closes in at 9. St. Mary's wins it 73-64. For Fenwick, Roman had 9, 3 3-point baskets. Hanks had 14, Grenard had 14, Gonzalez had 16. On the other side, Sacco had those 5 big points, 4 in the fourth period. Baden had a big basket. Calandris had a basket for 2. Batista got 6. Dietrich had a basket for 2. Merriman got those big 10 points in the fourth period. He finished with 10, all in the fourth period. Barry had 9 in the first half. He got 7 more in the second half to wind up with 16. And David Brown got them off and running in the first period with 14 points. He winds up with 30 for the game. He had 9 more in the third period and 7 more in the fourth period to help hold back Fenwick when they made those couple of runs. And Fenwick will stay alive in the tournament. They'll move to the semifinals. They'll play Archbishop Williams at Archbishop Williams at a time to be determined. But right now, they'll celebrate this big win over arch rival Fenwick as they beat them for the second time this year. St. Mary's 73, Fenwick 64. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm John Hoffman saying we'll see you next time.